Hallelujah. Glory be to God forever in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, thank you. It's very cold here in Canada, so you can see how I'm putting on my turtleneck. It's a little bit cold today, the weather out. I've shown you outside, you know, I'm just sitting on the window, but it's all snow everywhere. Even this tree behind my house here, it's really cold. Glory be to God. I'm your host, Sister Evangelist Atel. And my missionary, God bless you for tuning in today. I have something I want to talk today. It's about salvation. I know so many people, because when I go to do my missionary work or when I go to other places to tell people about the good news of the gospel, most of the people, the Muslim, the just the earthly people, you can say the carnal people, people who have not received the life of God, they always say that I'm a good person, so I will make it to heaven. So today I would just want to tell you that to be a good person cannot take you to heaven. Cornelius in the Bible, in the book of Acts, was a good man, was a very good man, but still he did not have salvation. God, he was praying and fasting one day, and God sent him. So God sent an angel to come and talk to him, because angels too are not allowed to preach the gospel. God gave the gospel only for the human flesh, this earthly vessel, to preach the gospel. So the angel came now and told him to go and call Peter, who is in the town or place, to come and tell them the gospel so that they can receive salvation. So now he sent his servants to go and bring Peter to come and tell them the good news. And the Bible says that when they came and tell them the good news, the Spirit of God fell upon them. And he even also gathered all his neighbors and his friends and his close relatives to come and hear that good news. And when they brought that good news, I mean, Peter came and started to tell them about Jesus Christ, that he died and rose again from the dead. And he was telling that God is irrespective of person. Before Peter even came, Peter had a vision that God showed him a sheet from heaven, and then there were all kind of animals and all kind of stuff. Then the Lord told him, I said, take it, kill it and eat. Peter said, no, I don't eat unclean things. And then God was telling him and say, everything that is clean, don't call it unclean. So he was talking about the Gentiles, because this Cornelius was one of the first fruit of the Gentiles who got saved, because salvation is for the Jews first and then for the Gentiles. So now this man was one of the first man. He was a good man, very good man. He give money to the poor, he do charity, he pray self and fast, but he was not born again. And so I just wanted to tell you, to be good cannot make you to go to heaven. If you are good, salvation come only through by faith, because through Adam's sin, one man sin, and all sin and fall short to the glory of God. That's what the Bible say. Adam was the first man who committed a treason and sin against God. Sin is a transgression against God's law. And Adam and the wife, they sin in the garden. So from there, all the human race sin. Even if a child is born today, is a sinner. The time of the child is just to pass here on the face of the earth, is just to find Jesus, to find salvation. If you don't find salvation, you are going to hell. That is just how it is. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, if you don't find salvation, you don't find the Lord Jesus Christ, you are going to hell. So you don't say that, oh, look, I'm good. And so people say, you, it's not fair though. It's not fair, you know, that all the other religions in the world, what about all the other religions? All the other religions in the world, they are cream white religion. They are fake. Their own salvation is established on good works. That means that you do good. And some Indian religions say it's like a karma thing. It's a circle. So Muslims say you do good, you pray five times a day, they will take you to heaven. No, that will not take you to heaven. It's only what Jesus finished on the cross of Calvary that will take you to heaven. Salvation come only by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ, because God made Jesus to be sin for us, because of the first man Adam, every human race sin. So every blood have sin in their bloodline, a curse in their bloodline. See, you pass through the cross, and then from there, that written code and the evil order and the ordinances that was against you, that was hanging on your neck, the death sentence will be removed according to the book of Colossians. They will be removed. The Bible says that Jesus Christ will blot out, he will forgive all your trespasses, blot out all the handwriting of ordinances that was against you, which was contrary to you. Took it out of your way, nailed them to his cross, having spoiled principality and power, he make a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. So salvation come only by the blood of Jesus Christ, the sacrifice, because without shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. That is why the Muslim people, they say, okay, they went to go and do the killing lamb. That lamb was representing Jesus Christ. That was the lamb without blemish and without spot. That lamb that Abraham took his own son to go and to the mountain to go and sacrifice, and go to Mount Moriah or something like that. And then God told him, I said, then the son was asking, say, Father, I see the fire and I see the sacrifice, so where is the lamb? And then Abraham said, God will provide, God himself will provide the lamb. Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God. Amen. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. That's why when John the Baptist came, he asked Jesus and asked and told people, I say, when Jesus came to his baptism in Jordan River, it says, behold the Lamb of God will take away the sin of the world. Jesus Christ is that Lamb of God will take away the sin of the world. I know the Muslim also asked many questions to me and say, yeah, but how can Jesus Christ be God and be man? Yes, Jesus Christ is God in the flesh, because God, nobody has ever seen God. Nobody can ever see God with your physical eye. You have never seen God, because God is spirit. And then Jesus Christ is the image of the invisible God. God invisible means that you cannot see it. And then Jesus Christ is that image of the invisible God. So Jesus, they say, yeah, they ask me questions too. I say, yeah, but how Jesus Christ die on the cross? How can God die? God does not die. The body of Jesus Christ died, but God did not die. The spirit that was in Jesus Christ was God the Father, is the spirit of God. So the body died, but God did not die. So that is the difference. So you have to know that God cannot die. Spirit does not die. Even you yourself, nobody has ever seen you. You are made in God's image, because you are a spirit being. You have a soul, which is your intellect, your emotion, your feeling, what you use on this physical realm. And then you have a body. If that is this container that is carrying that, your physical body cannot connect with God, because there is a different realm. There are different realms. There is spiritual realm and there is a physical realm. Your physical realm is only this body and your soul that connects with this physical realm. But your spirit connects with God in the spiritual realm. That is why when you want to connect with the spiritual realm, it's your spirit that connects. The Bible says that any God is a spirit, and those who worship him in spirit and in truth. So that you cannot connect God with your physical senses. You can connect God only in your spirit. So God talks to you only in the spirit, because God is spirit. God will not speak to you on your body, I will speak on your soul. You know, he speaks with your spirit, because God is spirit. You yourself, you are spirit. Nobody have ever seen you. They have seen only your body. Even if you die today, they will see only your body still put on that cover. Nobody have ever seen you, because God created you in his image. He put part of himself into you. So that is why you are a spirit being. Nobody have ever seen you. So Jesus Christ is that same. Jesus Christ is God. And you can see Jesus Christ's body, but you cannot see the spirit inside, which is God. Amen. So Jesus Christ is the image of the invisible God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Bible says now the Word became flesh. Jesus Christ is that Word who became flesh and dwell among us. Emmanuel means God is with us. Amen. In the name of Jesus. So your good works will not take you to heaven. The Bible says that if salvation could come through any good works that anybody can do, through the law or through good works, then Christ died in vain, the book of Galatians. So salvation do not come through that. Salvation come only through the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. We receive salvation, we receive righteousness as a free gift. So if you have not given your life today to Jesus, it is so easy. Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. And it is so easy. The work has been done already, finished on the cross of Calvary. It's only for you to repent and just say, Father, forgive me of all my sin. I know that now that I'm a sinner, through Adam's sin, I'm a sinner. My bloodline have sinned. Amen. In Jesus' name. So forgive me and wash me with your blood. Make me a new creation. Amen. And then find a good church who can baptize you in the water. That means to die with Jesus and raise again back from the dead. Amen. To have a new life. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus, to die to your sin. Amen. In Jesus' name. And then you find a new covenant book and start to read the epistle so that you can renew your mind as a new creation. Person, new creation man, with this new life you have now in Jesus. Amen. Glory be to God in Jesus Christ's mighty name. I have a this here. Anyone who wants it, you can write me down. I can send it to you. Jesus loves you in different languages, in Korea, in Chinese, in Hindu, in Russia, German, Finnish, Spanish, so many languages, and Arabic, any kind of language. So you can send, ask me, and I will send it to you for evangelism. You can give it to people and tell them that Jesus Christ loved them. Jesus died for their sin. He was raised again from the dead on the third day. He's now seated, raised now seated at the right hand of God the Father. Amen. In Jesus' name. And he's soon coming back again to take the church. Amen. So that is the good news of salvation. It is a free gift. You don't have to gamble with your life because it is a free gift. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you are new here, you can subscribe down below. Subscribing is free. It's just to promote the kingdom of God. Amen. In Jesus' name. And thank you for that. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. I will see you in the next audio or in the next video. Today is Sunday morning. I'm just preparing to go to church. So I said, let me bring this video clear quick and to tell the people that salvation does not come to that you are a good person. That's why you are saved. You are saved because it is a grace that God gives you. It's a free gift. The Bible says we are saved by grace through faith in the name of Jesus. Thank you. God bless you in Jesus' name.